Racing to the 2021 Breeders' Cup, and this time we get an update on the big dance for Old Del Mar on November 4th and 5th. Start off with a racing update from Saturday, the Lukas Classic. It was a all systems go performance by Knicks Go as he picks up a buyer speed figure of 104. He pretty much had this race in command from the start. He went wire to wire and picked up the victory at Churchill Downs. A mile and an eighth, a little over 147 and change, and a 104 buyer speed figure. He is probably gonna be the most likely favorite for the Breeders' Cup Classic. We'll be talking about that race a lot more. Meanwhile, in the awesome again, it was Medina Spirit going wire to wire, really securing that early position early, then opening up on the turn, and then kind of coasting in by over five lengths as he probably put together maybe his best overall performance. This one, the Kentucky Derby may have been a little bit grittier, but this was a good, solid race for Medina Spirit. In the Woodward Stakes, again, prevailing theme in the older division and in the Classic division this year has been wire-to-wire victories, and Art Collector goes wire-to-wire to win the Woodward Stakes. The American Pharoah Stakes, of course, on Friday, that was Corniche with a wire-to-wire performance. And about the only horse that came off the pace over the entire weekend, that was Ain't Easy with an 81 buyer speed figure. She will most likely go into the juvenile fillies, depending on Sunday's result with Echo Zulu in the Frisette Stakes. We're going to be updating another update later on this week with some of the performances from Sunday, as and also recapping some of the ARC and some of the other Europeans that are going to be pointing to the Breeders' Cup. All in all, an exciting day of racing on Saturday. Some pretty dominating performances, including some performances you didn't really see coming off the beginning of the day. Now, the latest update on the Breeders' Cup looks like this. Flightline is now out. He was potentially pointing for a sprint matchup with Jackie's Warrior, but they are now going to wait for the Malibu Stakes. Only two lifetime races. They want to put a little bit of distance into that next race and then maybe start to stretch them out. So Flightline will not be running in the Breeders' Cup. Mishriff, possibility of coming over for the turf, but he is not going to be running on the dirt in the Classic, according to trainer John Gosden. Of course, Knicks Go, he is going to ship out as late as possible, probably on November 1st on that last flight to California for Old Del Mar. He's going to train in Kentucky leading up to the race. And Happy Saver, Jay Privman reporting in the Daily Racing Form that he recently had a quarter crack. Now, the plan is still to run in the Breeders' Cup Classic. Juvenile, the field starting to take shape. Most likely contenders right now: Corniche, Papa Cap, Major General, Pinehurst, and Jack Christopher, after his big performance in the Champaign at the one turn mile. Gonna have to go two turns and ship out west to take on Pinehurst and Corniche. Classic division, I think we're going to be taking a big look at this race over the next couple of weeks, but the main contenders right now look like Essential Quality, Max Player, Happy Saver, Hot Rod Charlie, the winner of the Pennsylvania Derby the last time out, Knicks Go after his win in the Lukas Stakes, Medina Spirit, the wire-to-wire victor of the Awesome Again Stakes and the Kentucky Derby, and then Art Collector with that 107 buyer speed figure in the Woodward Stakes. He's now won three in a row for trainer Bill Mott, getting back into that three-year-old form that saw him win the Bluegrass Stakes and the Ellis Park Derby last year as a three-year-old. Art Collector putting it all together now as a four-year-old, and those are probably the top seven contenders for the Breeders' Cup Classic. You're also going to have Maxfield, possibility of Happy Saver, maybe Idol, Triple E probably still going to go, but that race shaping up as no clear-cut favorite. I do think Knicks Go, after that big performance on Saturday, and Essential Quality are going to get the bulk of the money in the Classic wagering. As you take a look at that sprint race now with the big victory by Dr. Shivel, it looks like Dr. Shivel, Forenzi Fire, will lead that division. CZ Rocket ran a good runner-up effort. He seems to be lacking some of that early speed, so it'll be interesting to see if we can get some pace in that sprint race. And then Jackie's Warrior, most likely the favorite in the Breeders' Cup Sprint. Now, the turf mile, again, a lot of these horses have ran against each other. Yesterday, another solid performance from Mo Forza. He's going to try to win that Breeders' Cup mile. Of course, he's going to have to take a rematch with Smooth Like Straight and Hit the Road. Most likely, Casa Creed and Got Stormy also in the turf mile. The dirt mile looking like the big three of Life is Good, Silver State, and Mind Control. I think they'll take most of the wagering in that dirt mile division, with Life is Good putting in a big performance the last time out in the Kelso. There was talk of Art Collector maybe going to the dirt mile, but after that Woodward performance, I think we'll most likely see him in the Breeders' Cup Classic and a 107 buyer speed figure for him. Now the Euros are starting to indicate their interest. Big race, Mischief going to go to the turf. Walton Street possibility to the turf after his Woodbine victory. Master of Seas to the turf mile. Mother Earth to the filly and mare division. She's going to take on War Goddess. And then the juvenile turf, Charlie Appleby sending over a couple most likely. Modern Games and Elba Her, most recently a victor at Woodbine. So more Euros going to be announced in the next week or two as we start to take a look at some of those Euros coming over. They're always having a big impact in some of the turf races, and that classic division shaping up as a 8-9 top contenders, and then probably most likely 10 or 11 horses in that Breeders' Cup Classic. The sprint race could be light, could maybe only see 7 or 8 horses in that division. And I think the two juvenile races might only have 8-9 horses, as there's just not enough horses really winning these prep races. And then I'm not so sure a lot of the East Coast horses are going to want to ship west. So a lot of the field still to be shaken out. For Sunday, we've still got the Frazette Stakes and the Zenyatta Stakes to run, so we'll update those divisions later on this week as we race you to the 2021 Breeders' Cup at Old Del Mar.